Hello all. Today we are going to discuss how we are going to manage asset allocation to the employees within the organization. After an employee joins, assets are allocated to him like a mobile, laptop, a desktop, a furniture, and so on. And once they go out of the company or exit the company, these assets are taken back. Apart from that, there is a possibility that some of the assets can be exchanged in case some assets go wrong or they require repair. To manage the assets, you will be first defining different kinds of assets. Let's take some example. For example, a laptop. For a laptop, you can define what are the mandatory items to be defined: brand, model, mobile number, for example, mobile phone. Then we need to define different kinds of brands. This is for managing the assets and its information. For example, Lenovo. We can define different kinds of model numbers for each and every asset type. And we can define asset tags if required. To process the asset, first we need to define an asset within the system. We choose the asset type, we choose the make or brand number, we define the model number, we assign a particular serial number, after that we click on save. The system will auto generate the asset description. Once an asset is created, then we can market it to ready state, and after ready state, it means it is ready to be allocated. We can mark it as available. Once it is marked as available, then it will be available and can be allocated to different employees. To do the allocation, we need to go to asset allocation window. We click on asset allocation. We choose the employee from the list. We choose create asset, add an item. We choose a particular asset. We choose asset type. All the asset types of laptop which are right now available is only one will come up. If I try to choose the different asset, let's say mobile phone, I can see one more asset which is available. I click on save. As an executive, I will submit this for approval to my manager, who will receive an email that a particular asset is allocation is pending for his approval. The manager can approve or refuse this request. Let's do an approval. After an approval is done, it comes back to the HR executive, who can now confirm the allocation or cancel the allocation as per the need. I click on confirm location and the allocation is now done. Okay. The system keeps a record of allocation date, request date, and so on. Now, once the asset allocation is done, if I look at the asset which has been allocated, you can see that it has now showing that this is particularly assigned to the employee that I had chosen and the department. In the asset movement also, I would be able to see that right now this asset is allocated to so and so at so and so time. Once an employee is about to exit the company, or in between, if there is a requirement to change the asset, then we can do that by clicking on asset change or return. You can choose the employee. The system will show all the assets which are currently allocated to them. We can define the reason for change or return. For example, exit. So I am not defining new asset. That means I am doing an exit. I submit this for approval. Again, it goes to the manager who can approve or refuse. He approves, finally process the request, and the asset has now been returned to the organization. If I look back and check the asset, you can now see that it is no more assigned to the employee. It has now gone into hold stage, and you can see that the action shows change. So it is no more belonging to Mr. Bharat. Now, after the asset is coming back to us, the HR team can either send it to for selling, can mark it as lost, can scrap it, can send it for repair, or mark it as available back again in case we want to do reallocation. So based on the scenario, you can click on different buttons. As soon as I mark it available, it is now available again for allocation purpose. So that's all for asset management. Thank you very much.
Like, share and subscribe our YouTube channel videos, and you will be getting a lot. And yes, don't forget to comment upon these videos, because if you comment on these videos, this will really going to give us the motivation to upload more and more videos. Thank you so much. Stay tuned.